Welcome to the 30th lecture in this lecture series introducing international investment law. In the last two lectures, we dealt with the most favored nation standard. In this lecture, we deal with an interesting topic under MFN, that is extension of MFN to procedural rules. To recollect, MFN clause obligates the host state to extend a treatment to nationals of other contracting party the most favorable treatment that such host state granted to nationals of third parties. Note that we are studying MFN under substantive treatment. Thus, the aim of the MFN clause is to establish the same rules of play for all foreign investors in competition in a given country and to prevent any nationality-based distortions. Even so, we see that some tribunals have applied MFN clauses to procedural provisions such as dispute resolution. In fact, MFN clauses have been used as a foundation to circumvent requirements under treaties for bringing disputes before domestic tribunals. Emilio Agustin Maffesini versus the Kingdom of Spain, decision on jurisdiction dated 25 January 2000 is an example. Maffesini invoked arbitration before the ICSID under the Spain-Argentina BIT of 1991. Spain raised jurisdictional objections, including the one contained in Article 10, sub-Article 2 of the treaty, which stated, if the dispute cannot thus be settled within 6 months following the date on which the tribunal has been raised by either party, it shall be submitted to the competent tribunal of the contracting party in whose territory the investment was made. Therefore, Article 10 sub Article 2 obligated the parties to submit the dispute to the local court in the contracting party, which is Spain in this case. However, Maffesini argued that he was not obligated to approach the local courts in Spain because of the MFN clause. The MFN clause in the treaty stated, in all matters subject to this agreement, this treatment shall not be less favorable than extended by each party to the investments made in its territory by investors of a third country. Maffesini contended that Spain had, in its 1991 BIT with Chile, not provided for the local exhaustion rule. Therefore, the argument was that Spain was obligated pursuant to the MFN clause to extend that treatment under the Argentina BIT as well. The tribunal surprisingly allowed this and held. From the above considerations, it can be concluded that if a third party treaty contains provisions for settlement of disputes that are more favorable to the protection of the investors' rights and interests than those in the basic treaty, such provisions may be extended to the beneficiary of the most favored nation clause as they are fully compatible with the ejus dem generis principle. Subsequently, several tribunals have decried these positions. These decisions are listed below. Three of them are Salini Constructori versus Jordan, Plama Consortium versus Bulgaria, Telenor Mobile versus Hungary. Even so, several tribunals have followed the Maffesini decision. These include Siemens versus Argentina, Gas Natural versus Argentina, Hochtief versus Argentina, Suez versus Argentina, National Grid versus Argentina, AWG Group versus Argentina, Impregilo versus Argentina, Ross Invest Company versus Russia, Rent 4 versus Russia. We see that most of these decisions are against Argentina or Russian Federation. The criticism against these decisions is that before Maffesini, states never envisaged the possibility that MFN clause would be extended to procedural provisions. Another criticism is that MFN clause could be used to develop or misused to develop a super treaty by bypassing various provisions in the basic treaty. Suzy Nikiema argues the presence of MFN and the way in which it has been interpreted in recent years constitutes a potential obstacle to the reforms proposed worldwide or within any country. As a response, many BITs entered into the last decade do not contain an open-ended MFN clause. These specifically exclude dispute resolution provisions. For instance, Article 3, Subarticle 2 of the Colombia UK BIT 2010 states, the most favorable treatment to be granted in like circumstances referred to in this agreement does not encompass mechanisms for the settlement of investment disputes, such as those contained in Articles 9 and 10 of this agreement, which are provided for in treaties or in international investment agreements. Likewise, Article 5, Subarticle 4 of the Switzerland-Georgia BIT of 2014 provides, it is understood that the most favored nation treatment referred to in paragraphs 2 and 3 does not apply to investment dispute resolution mechanisms provided by this agreement or by other agreements made by the contracting party concerned. More on the MFN clause in the next lecture. Meanwhile, if any reader wants to comment on any aspect relating to international investment law, please feel free to write at lawbadri@gmail.com. The references used for this lecture are provided here, as well as in the description to this video. Bye-bye, stay safe.